Good evening. How are you doing? Are you excited for the night? Yay! Tonight, to usher in the spirit of Christmas, St. Oliver Plunkett, our parish, we are having the Christmas concert. The concert wherein we will bring the joy of Christmas alive through the participation of two of our great teams. The first part of our Christmas concert is A Silent, Noisy Night. I don't know how that goes, you know, A Silent, Noisy Night, we will know. And it will be presented by St. Oliver's Roots students, coordinated by none other than Amy Tolmage, you know. And in the second part, we will have I Call Him Lord, a Christmas concert presented by St. Oliver Plunkett Choir, featuring our adult choir and guest musicians. So without any further talk, let us welcome the first part of our concert, A Silent, Noisy Night.
It may have been a silent night when Jesus came to earth, or it may have been a noisy night to celebrate his birth. I wonder if the cows all mooed. The horses must have neighed. Could little goats have bleated loud and led the grand parade? While chickens clucked, and duckies quacked. To celebrate the boy, the birdies chirped, and donkeys brayed. Yeehaw! Yeehaw! And mice all squeaked with joy. The angels broke their silence on the hillside with their song. They sang their alleluias as the shepherds hummed along.
Hallelujah.
I think the sheep began to baa and raccoons made a peep. The crickets chirped, coyotes howled. No creature stayed asleep. The shepherds must have hollered as they spread the news around. Perhaps the townsfolk danced and sang and added to the sound. With moos and neighs and bleats of joy, with clucks and quacks of praise, the animals all celebrated in their special ways. With chirps and squeaks and brays and peeps, and angels singing proud, with shouts and dancing, snorts and cheers, it must have been quite loud. Yes, Jesus is our Savior and a gift from God above. He brings us hope and peace and joy and everlasting love. It's hard to stay so silent when we've heard the greatest news. Let's celebrate our Savior's birth with neighs and chirps and moos. But that's not right, because we are not those horses, cows, or birds. We can celebrate our Lord with actions, songs, and words. Let's spread the love of Jesus Christ and good news with delight. Let's share his peace and joy like that first noisy Christmas night.
Thank you. Tonight, we gather together in this place to sing and rejoice, for God's gift has come. He is our Emmanuel and the Savior of our hearts. As the Magi journeyed ever closer to the one they sought, after so many years in darkness, so many fears and questions, waiting for an answer, so many miles traveled, searching for a sign, then they see a star. His star, shining and glorious, we have seen his star.
Searching for a sign, we have seen his
We remember that starry night when our God became flesh and dwelt among us. We celebrate that holy night when the voice of Almighty God was heard in the frail cries of a baby, and the world witnessed a spark that would blaze into the greatest act of love that the world has ever known. And we long once again to come and adore him. For thousands of years, God's people had waited for the Messiah. For 400 years, God's people longed to hear the voice of their God. And then everything changed on that first Christmas day when Jesus, our King, was born. After seeing the star in the east, The wise men rejoiced and traveled a great distance to worship Jesus. The shepherds were astonished and terrified by the sight of the angelic host. They too journeyed to bow before him. After seeing the Christ child in the temple, Simeon was overcome with praise at the sight of the Messiah. As we pause to remember, our hearts are also overwhelmed by this baby because he is the one the world was waiting for. He is our Emmanuel. He is the Savior and Lord of the world. We believe what the prophet Isaiah declared so long ago. A child will be born for us. A son will be given to us, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. The dominion will be vast, and its prosperity will never end. He will reign on the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish and sustain it with justice and righteousness from now and forever. In the small town of Nazareth, the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and told her she would give birth to a son and name him Jesus. In a dream, an angel told Joseph, Mary's betrothed, he should not be afraid to take Mary as his wife and to name the child Jesus. As they each heard this, Mary and Joseph knew that this name was unlike any other. Jesus, the name that would cast out fear, cause demons to tremble, and bring salvation to anyone who would call upon it. The name that would be worshiped for all eternity. Jesus, the Son of God, is worthy of his name because he humbled himself, became a man, lived a sinless life, and was obedient unto death. Jesus, the name that is above every name, at which every knee will bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole empire should be registered. So everyone went to be registered, each to his own town. Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered along with Mary, who was engaged to him and was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. Then she gave birth to her firstborn son, and she wrapped him tightly in cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. This babe, whose name had all the authority and majesty, was born in the lowliest of places. He was the very Word who spoke the galaxies into existence and created all things. While Mary was tenderly holding him, he was the Savior who would later promise to prepare a place in heaven for all who would believe in him. And yet, on the night of his birth, there was no room for him. Can you sense the divine irony of this moment? Most everyone in Bethlehem missed the wondrous miracle that had taken place in that humble state and stable. While their physical bodies were so close, their hearts were so far. Today, we are not all that different from those in Bethlehem that night. Christ is here, right here in our midst, and he is looking for a place, a heart, that he might love and fill the new life once again.
Thou didst leave thy throne and thy holy crown when thou camest to earth for me. But in Bethlehem's home was there found no room for thy holy nativity. Oh,
Jesus left his throne of highest glory to be with us and become one of us. Though his rightful place was one of wonder and majesty, he humbled himself and came as a meek and precious child. We celebrate Christmas because of what this day brought to a hurting and hopeless world. Hope, healing, peace, love, and joy, and salvation were born to us that day. Jesus is the complete fulfillment of every divine promise and the answer to every longing heart. May our response to him be just as they were for May we surrender our past, present, and future to the sovereign hand of Jesus, our Lord.
Let's give them a big round of applause. Yes. Hi, those up in the choir loft, yes. Choir loft? No, I mean, they are at the balcony, I should say. It was a beautiful night. Is it not? Was it not a beautiful night? I'd like to congratulate, first of all, our the cast and crew of the Silent Noisy Night, our young kids. Where are they? Where are they? Yeah, yeah. Thank you, Amy, and your daughters who really worked hard to put up that presentation. We always enjoy the kids, you know, when they come up because of the pure joy that they bring is always an added feature. And the best part of Christmas is the children. And it's all about the children, how God has come among us as a child and bring tremendous joy to our lives. We thank you for your participation and all that you've done. And secondly, of course, our adult choir, I Call Him Lord, the presentation that was organized, orchestrated, and conducted by Lucas McHenry. Let's give him a big round of applause. Yay! I don't take it lightly when I say that one of the best things that has happened to our parish is to get Lucas McHenry to be our music director. Thank you, Lucas, for all the hard work that you put in. You had done an amazing job in the last couple of years, including the small kids. They have been such a beautiful gift, and you have been such a blessing to our parish community. And we thank you, Samantha, the whole family. Thank you so much for all that you bring to the parish community, your gift, your talent. And I'd like to also acknowledge our soloist, Bella Marquez. Bella? As many of you know, she's she made it to the Dean's List at the Belmont University in Nashville last week. So we congratulate her and thank her for her beautiful gift of the music that you bring to us. Many more blessings to you as you continue your studies. Our guest musicians, I want to acknowledge Tim Johnson, Drew Simpson, Janine Kinsey, Melvin Jordan, Charles Brown, of course, Diane Lux, and of course, Fritz Seiler, Jerry Farr, Rudy Wilson, Glenda Smith, Marison English, Wally Conrath. Yes, let's give them a big round of applause. Yes, yes, our big round of applause. Our lights and camera, John Santos, and soundboard, Mike Cable. And slides, Don Urquhart, and of course, our lecturer and musician, Peg Basic. Let's give them a round of applause. Around. This is the first time that we have a, what do you call that, interpreter, you know, for those who sign language specialist, Kathy Byrne. Thank you for being here. Thank you. To one and all, thank you very much. We have a couple of days left for our celebration of Christmas. We thank you and we bless you for being here this evening. Please don't forget the our ministry, who takes care of providing for refreshments. They are all here, and they have a lot of goodies at the family center. So please drop by and have a celebration tonight. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. God bless you all. I ask the choir to please come up here. We are going to just take a picture over here.
Thank you all. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. Thank you all so much.
So this choir.
Thank you so much. Thank you all. Merry Christmas to you all. Beautiful job. Thank you so much for the gift. I love you all. Wonderful job. So proud of you. Awesome. Thank you. Let's go party. Yeah, we got to do a picture at the altar, please. Yes.